Good afternoon. As you just have heard from the President of the Security Council for July, the Security Council has agreed to allow the President to make press remarks, which is very firm and clear for the act that the DPRK has done on July 4th. Seven ballistic missiles have been launched by DPRK on that day, and it's a very clear violation of Security Council Resolution 1718-1974. And the council, member of the council agree that this is not acceptable, so they condemn, and the CLS express grave concern on this. And reminded the DPRK of a full obligation to comply all these resolutions, particularly 1874, and also emphasized the importance of the expeditious work on completion of the work of 1718 committee, which has been mandated to complete the work to designate the entities and the individual within 30 days, which falls 12th of July, very soon. And also emphasize the importance of political and diplomatic solution. And also members agreed to monitor the situation closely and come back if it's necessary. Well, as far as Japan is concerned, we requested this meeting today and argue that Security Council should send a clear message immediately and promptly. And as a result of this, we could agree on this one. I think it should be good. You know that in general term, our focus and priority is effective implementation of measures that has been agreed on June 1874. There is no, I think, a doubt about that importance. But at the same time, when this DPRK act in violation of resolutions of Security Council, I think Security Council should respond calmly, but also responsibly, proportionately to the act that they have done. And I think what I think agreed upon today is appropriate for that action, so that we welcome this action that Council has agreed today. Thank you very much. Any question?
The DPRK in the last 3 or 4 months have fired off about 15 missiles, all of which are capable of reaching Japan. They seem to be unresponsive to any of the Security Council's resolutions or demands. Are we moving closer to the point where the Council is going to have to consider a blockade of the North Korean ports in order for the resolutions to be adhered to by the DPRK?
You recall that some of the missiles that the DPRK launched are not utilizing ballistic missile technology. And this time on this July 4th, and the seven missiles are using ballistic missile technology. And I think the position of Security Council is very clear, that any launch using ballistic missile technology, not missile itself, is in violation. So therefore, earlier launch by missile, the Security Council didn't meet, didn't react. We just calmly. But this time, it is a violation. That's why we met today. But at the same time, if this situation continues, what is going to happen next stage? I really think that the Council, that's why it's important Council met today. Not probably the meeting in such way that the DPRK wanted us to behave in accordance their own timetable and according their space. Council should judge situation very closely and monitor carefully. And in case they do some act in violation of Security Council resolutions, then we should act promptly and proportionately, I mentioned. I don't want to speculate what is going to happen in future. You are quite right that DPRK, regrettably so far, hasn't responded positively to the appeals, unanimous appeal and message that the Security Council has issued. But I think it is my personal assessment of the situation that Council has been unanimously acting so far all the time on this issue, including all countries. And that I think at this moment, what I would say is instead of talking about what is additional measures, as you mentioned, like whatever blockade and other things, what is, as I emphasize, the important thing is to fully and effectively implement what has been agreed upon in Resolution 1874, namely cargo inspection and also the financial measures and also the arms embargo. These are the very, very effective measures if everybody is implementing. And I think our effort should be concentrating on this aspect rather than to think about additional measures.
But if violations continue? won't additional harsher measures have to be employed by the council?
Well, this is the area that I really don't want, and it's not appropriate for me to speculate at this moment. Obviously, as I say, council should act, I would say, calmly, responsibly, and also proportionately. If the provocative, continuous provocative action require the additional measures, obviously, time may come. But at this moment, I don't think it is a situation. We should focus on the implement what we have agreed upon, rather than to think about additional thing. Any other questions?
What did Japan think of the whole incident? Where do you have any information of where the ship was going, and are you satisfied by the outcome today?
Well, as you see that Japan has approached all countries in the Southeast Asia. In general term, their obligation as a member state of the United Nations to fully implement measures that has been agreed by the Security Council, including cargo inspection. When they come to the port, that is obligation. I mean, this we urged and we expect them to take measures. The means cargo inspection, other things, and reminded of all these obligations. And I think it is good that the DPRK got that message, that wherever they go, that any port or countries in the region will be cooperating in compliance with resolutions. And probably that will be the reason why they changed the directions. I think it is a welcome development. And all countries, I think, should follow up faithfully. And that is the most effective way. I think it's also partially a response to the earlier questions.
Did Japan convey that message to Myanmar? And separately, what do you think the Secretary General's trip to Myanmar? Do you view it as a success, or as some say, a failure in that he didn't meet with Aung San Suu Kyi?
Well, let me just focus on this the North Korean the issues. Obviously, the Myanmar is a country in Southeast Asia, and all other countries, not necessarily Myanmar. Japan has approached bilaterally and reminded them and the full cooperation with the United Nations in implementation of resolution of Security Council. Separate matter on this, the Secretary General's visit to Myanmar, it's too early for me to make a public assessment of this. I have been very closely, consulting with Secretary General and the Special Representative Gambari before and during the trip. But after the trip, Secretary General went to Europe. And I think after he returned to New York headquarters, we'll have opportunity to get a full briefing from him directly. And I think that would be an opportunity that we could address.
Ambassador, what good are these resolutions 1718 and 1874 if they continue launching missiles? What good are these resolutions?
Well, I think you shouldn't jump into that conclusion. As I say, that, this is in fact a very visible and very clear case. One of the DPRK ships was heading toward somewhere destination in Southeast Asia, and they turned direction, So what is this? Is it because of 1874? And their member state in the region taking the measures to comply with this one. So that's why I think it's sending a clear not only message, but changing the, I think, behavior. We hope that DPRK, they stop launching the missile, stop doing all provocative acts eventually. And I think the pressure and the dialogue should work hand in hand. And we know that the diplomatic also effort has been going on. So I think the two resolutions, as you mentioned, are extremely important because it's unanimously adopted, including China and Russia, all countries in the region. And I think the DPRK is getting, in reality, message. That is why I think they started to behave slightly differently. And I think we should continue work on that. Yes.
In the elements to the press, there was an element of you appeal to all parties to refrain from activities that would aggravate the situation. Yet the DPRK has said that any inspection of their ship they would treat as an act of war and respond in turn. Have you discussed this in the council? And what does this mean to appeal to all countries to refrain from activities to aggravate the situation, when the DPRK considers enforcing the resolution as an act which could aggravate?
What I'd like to stress here is that what the President laid out this afternoon is a summary of the discussion of the Council members this afternoon. In other words, there is the overwhelming, how do you call this, view, a common point on the what I think nature of DPRK's launch of ballistic missiles. It's very clear. However, what is needed beyond that? There are some, how to call this, members who argue that we should continue to have a pressure. That's you know, the most effective way. Other, the hardcore members will argue that equally, I think diplomacy should be the given the opportunity to find a solution on this one. And how to call this provocative action should not lead to another the escalation from other countries. Instead, we should try to calm down the situation. And those there are views like this. And this should, the, these all different views should be reflected as a kind of consensus. That is what has been, I think, summarized by President. So I really am not in a position to, you know, explain those of my colleagues who argue that kind of language is necessary. And what I would try to say is that, and I think I agree with that, that in a sense that we should not, we should deal with the situation calmly, but at a time responsibly. In other words, the you know that the we should not I mean Security Council should not be dictated by the pace and how do you call this timing of action by DPRK. We should be in control of the situation and try to deal with the situation calmly, not kind of overreacting. And this is, I think, the idea I think behind this kind of. Language. In other words, we should try to contain this situation. Don't take it emotionally, calmly, I mean, take it calmly, and try to diffuse the emotional tension as much as possible. Okay, thank you very much.